Can anyone imagine a crime-free society? No, because some individuals in every society indulge in criminal activities. What is meant by crime? Crime is simply an act that violates a law. Every crime is a deviant act, but not all deviants are criminals. For instance, lunatics, alcoholics, homosexuals, cross-dressers, adulterers, and all liars are deviants. Can you say all these deviants are criminals? No. Since we cannot punish cross-dressers, liars and homosexuals legally. Crime definition. Many scholars have given the definition of crime. Let us look into two such definitions. Hall Jerome has defined crime as legally forbidden and intentional act which has a harmful impact on social interest, which has a criminal intent and which has legally prescribed punishment for it. Selin has described it as violation of conduct norms of the normative groups. Classification of crime. There are various types of crimes in the society. Most crimes can be fit into any one of the following categories. They are crime against persons, crime against property, social order crime, or crime against morality, white collar crime, organized crime. Crimes against persons. These crimes always involve violence and the use of threat or force to injure victims. Violent crimes include murder and homicide, forcible rape, robbery, and aggravated assault. Crime against property. These crimes do not involve the threat of force or injury to victims, rather the goal of perpetrators is to gain possession of or to destroy property by unlawful means. Property crime includes burglary, larceny, that is theft, motor vehicle theft and arson. Generally speaking, we come across such crimes more commonly than violent crimes. Say for example, burglary, vehicle theft and so on. Social order crime or crime against morality. Criminal acts such as gambling, prostitution, illegal drug use and public drunkenness offend the moral sensibilities of the majority. These crimes are often referred to as victimless crimes because no other person is allegedly hurt. However, it is obvious that perpetrators themselves become victims of such crimes and very often their families. White collar crime. Let us study this elaborately in our later part of this section. Organized crime. The criminal activity of groups who organize to maximize the efficiency and minimize the danger of apprehension and punishment is collectively called organized crime. Organized crime is in the business of satisfying human wants that are prohibited by the ideal norms of society and by the legal codes. Now, let us move on to crime in India. Every year, crime in our society is escalating. According to Crime in India 2010 report, the incidence and rate of crime has increased drastically between the year 2005 and 2010. Moreover, the report states that population is one of the factors influencing the incidence of crime. There is a positive correlation between the growth of incidence and the population of the country. Besides population, the other factors influencing the crime incidence of a particular place could be growing urbanization, leading to migration of population from neighboring places, unemployment, income disparity, etc. Delinquency. Let us first understand the concept of delinquency. Delinquency can be broadly defined as a problem displayed among the minor. If antisocial behaviors and crimes are noticed among teenagers or young men and women who are below the age of 18 years are called delinquent acts or delinquency. Therefore, juvenile delinquents or minors who commit crime at very young age. As per the definitions of juveniles in the Juvenile Justice Act 1986, male below the age of 16 years and female below the age of 18 years were considered as juveniles. The act was amended in 2000, according to which the age of juvenile for both male and female was brought at par as below the age of 18 years. From this, we can come to a conclusion that the major difference between criminal and delinquent is the age of the perpetrator committing the crime. The term crime refers to the offences committed at a matured age, whereas the term delinquency refers to the offences committed at a prematured age. According to Elrod and Ryder, delinquency consists of those behaviors that are prohibited by the family or juvenile code of the state and that subject minors to the jurisdiction of juvenile court. Delinquency in India. Delinquency is a social problem which is increasing day by day and has become a concern for parents, teachers, and community members. In spite of the adverse socio-economic conditions, India's delinquency rates are still comparatively low. Research by Harjan and Priyadashni and Harjan and Ketaneni suggests that features of strong family relationships, caste networks, and economic interdependence of family caste members in Indian society impede associational patterns that may be conducive to delinquency orientations a youth may acquire. According to Crime in India 2010 report, juvenile delinquency has gradually increased every year since 2000. The report claims that the significant increase in 2001 was mainly due to increase in the upper age of male juvenile from 16 years to 18 years as per Juvenile Justice Act 2000. A total of 30,303 juveniles were apprehended during 2010, out of which 28,763 were boys and 1,540 were girls. In our society, girl children are enforced to adhere to the norms of the society. From the report, it can be said that the juvenile delinquents are insignificant in amount due to double standards existing in our society. Fortunately, such practices have kept them away from delinquent activities. White collar crime. When we talk of crime, we imagine it as the work of disadvantaged young men from poor familial background. But the sociologist Edwin Sutherland challenged the traditional image of criminals and predominant etiological theories of crime of his day. In Sutherland's view, poverty and social disorganization could not be seen as the primary causes of crime. Crime could also be found among people who grew up in good neighborhoods and good homes and lived in situations of authority and privileges. Sutherland is credited with introducing the concept white collar crime in the middle decades of last century. For Sutherland, white collar crime is the crime committed by a person of respectability and high social status in the course of his occupation. Sutherland indicated white collar to refer business managers and executives. He used this notion to challenge conventional stereotypes and theories. The white collar criminals he identified were often middle-aged men of respectability and high social status. They lived in affluent neighborhoods and they were well respected in the community. White collar crime includes both occupational crime and corporate crime. Occupational crime refers to the crime in which individuals commit crimes in the course of their employment, whereas corporate crime includes corporate law violation in the interest of maximizing profit. Occupational crime is motivated by individual gain. Employee theft of merchandise or pilferage is one of the most common types of occupational crime. Other examples include embezzlement, forgery and counterfeiting and insurance fraud. Price fixing, antitrust violations and security fraud are all examples of corporate crime which benefits the organization. Let me make you very clear by giving some of white collar crimes. White collar crime involves smuggling, food adulteration, atmospheric environmental pollution, pollution of water resources, violation of foreign exchange regulations, counterfeiting currency, racketeering in passports and cultural property, illegal exploitation of employees, evasion of laws, tax laws, kickbacks in transactions involving foreign and international firms, black marketing in scarce goods, bank frauds, violation of drug control regulations, corruption in government and public and private sectors. Performing illegal abortions, illegal services to criminals, infringement of patents, trademarks and copyrights and unfair labor practices. What might be the reason for an individual to get involved in white collar crimes? One obvious reason is politicians, government bureaucrats, bank officials and business executives have the opportunities to access to the resources, and it is believed to be an easy way of money making to lead a luxurious life. Dr. Barnes points out that need and greed explain most crimes, and it is the latter grounds, greed, which is the most potent factor in these cases. The other common reason is lack of morality and ethical values, which is declining among the white collars. Impact of white collar crime. Over the years, not only the number of white collar crimes in India has gone up, but their spread and variety has also increased. The problem of white collar crime is enormously complex. It raises difficult social, legal and theoretical issues that have important implications for society and for the field of criminology. Sutherland has maintained that the white collar crimes are dangerous to the society than the crimes committed by the members of the lower classes of the society. The reason is that the financial losses are higher and are inflicted directly on the public morals. The losses incurred through white collar crime are far higher than that of petty crimes. Economic offenses not only inflict pecuniary losses on individuals, but also damage the national economy. The victim of such crime is normally the entire community, society, organization or entire nation besides the individuals. Let us elaborately discuss on contemporary white collar crime, which is sending shockwaves in every society. Corruption is a global problem. It is found in every society in one or the other form. Bribe is paid for getting both the right and wrong things done at the right time. It undermines the stability and efficiency of a society's government. According to a former chief vigilance commissioner, compared, just as AIDS knocks out the immune system of the human body, corruption knocks out the immune system in the form of checks and balances designed to ensure rule of law and take society towards anarchy. Corruption in simple terms may be described as an act of bribery. It has also been described as the use of public power for private profits in a way that constitutes a breach of law or a deviation from the norms of society. Corruption is spread over in the society in several forms. For these, the major ones, bribery, nepotism, misappropriation, patronage, and favoritism. Though the term corruption has wide connotations, the following patterns of behavior among public servants can be described as corrupt within the provisions of law. Acceptance of gratification as reward for work done in an official capacity, obtaining any object or pecuniary advantage illegally, fraudulent misappropriation of public property, being in possession of financially resource or property disproportionate to one's known sources of income, misuse or abuse of official position, borrowing money or purchasing a costly article from a person with whom one has official dealings with a known understanding that the borrowed money will not be returned. Disregard of neglect of rules purposely to help the citizen in avoiding dues, tax, duty due to be paid to government. Refusal to do a duty on some plea which may benefit the other party. Example, police officer not registering a case to protect a criminal. Causes of corruption can be categorized as economic, social, political and legislative. The economic causes include craze for higher living standards. Everyone wished to live a comfortable life. Some people could not able to fulfill their wishes morally. Inflation. The general rise in the prices of services and goods. Profiteering tendencies. Desire to have maximum profit in every business in which one is doing. Lack of morality in business community. The social causes include materialistic outlook of life. Craze to live in an affluent atmosphere. Erosion of social values. Illiteracy. Acquisitive cultural traits. Tendency to buy new valuables like property, jewels and other possessions. Public indifference. People's lack of interest towards corrupt behavior. The political causes include political patronage. Without the support of political background, corruption does not thrive. Hence, politics play a key role in corruption. Ineffective political leadership. In most of the cases, political leaders themselves are corrupted. They turn a blind eye to unscrupulous activities in the state. Political immorality. The legislative factors are inadequate legislation, loopholes in law, carelessness in the implementation of law. Corruption in India. You know, where does India stand in world level in terms of corruption? According to Corruption Perception Index 2011 by Transparency International, a German-based NGO has ranked India to be in 95th position out of 183 countries with 3.1 score. According to it, New Zealand is the least corrupted country with 9.5, followed by Denmark, Finland, Sweden and Singapore. Somalia and North Korea are at the bottom with one score and the most corrupted country in the world by CPI. India cannot take consolation from Somalia and North Korea since scores less than 5 are considered to be extensively corrupt. Transparency and accountability are significant in effective functioning of the system. Inefficiency would certainly pull back the country's progress. It is disgusting that politicians and top bureaucrats take bribe and embezzle money, which is allocated for public welfare programs. The victims of corruption are ultimately the poor, who are expecting some improvement in their living standards. It is estimated that out of the total cost sanctioned for any project, almost 70% is invested in the work, 20% on contractors' profit and 10% goes to various officers' pocket. It is paradoxical that thieves who commit theft for feeding his hungry children are promptly put behind the bars. Those who plunder crores of public money remain outside with all those paraphernalia with power. Conclusion. According to Emily Durkheim, the eminent French sociologist, crime is normal and not pathological condition. He believed that there will never be a completely crime-free society, because if everyone is rich, the rich will rob the richer. However, if crime in any society is unchecked, it may pose a serious threat to the country's progress. In Indian society, in spite of host of legislative provisions to curb the crime-related problems, we succumb to it. Importantly, it is because of failure in enforcement of laws. The government should enforce the laws on citizens to ensure in minimizing the crime. The control mechanism may be adopted either through formal or informal social control. Additionally, individuals and communities should play a dynamic role in addressing crime-related social problems.